Mandi Harkett, welcome to the show.
Hello, thank you so much for having me.
Looking good, very summery there.
Trying to inject some summer into my normal life at home.
I know for a fact you are a lady of many talents, which we will talk about in a moment. Well, I'm going to come in straight in with lockdown this time. We've left that out of the story a little bit. It's getting a little bit too many lockdowns, but I want to mention that because you've been very proactive in lockdown. Tell me about that.
I've been proactive in terms of I've got a lot of friends who dealt with isolation on their own, and I've done quite a few things to merely, really more than anything, to entertain them. And I started with the creation of my daily ditties. Union's been on strike. Which is me taking a song and doing two verses and a chorus, like a sort of shortened version of a song, and making big a cappella mashup with me and my ukulele. And that ran, I think I did that 32 days in a row, which trying to organise a full arrangement of a different song every day in 24 hours was a challenge, but I really, really enjoyed it. So that kept me definitely very busy during lockdown when it all first happened. And I'm still creating now, and I know that, you know, it gives people a little bit of joy, which makes me happy.
Well, that sounds like a big uke challenge, 32 songs in 32 days. What was the genre of music? What did you cover? Jazz, pop, blues, pop songs? What did you play?
I challenged myself to try and do a different genre every day. So it kind of goes with my history of my music career, really. I trained as a classical singer, and so I've done quite a few classical songs, but at the same time, I did Bon Jovi's Living on a Prayer, which for people who knew me was bizarre, and I crimped my hair. I went proper full out 80s in the costume as well, and did silly things like using my fusion bag actually as percussion, and silly stuff like that. Music, turned dance songs into acoustic tracks, went back to my youth a little bit and did some Alanis Morissette, so sort of along the rock side of things, because that's what I love to listen to as well. It's not fair to deny me of the
cross I bear that you gave to me, you. I think that's great. Again, the power of the ukulele. You can go from classical to Bon Jovi, big mullet haircuts.
Anything's possible.
You've got several strings to bear. Well, I want to talk about the something you're doing different with the ukulele. We'll do that in a second. But you've also been an actor as well.
Yes, I'm very lucky. I've trained, I did a master's degree in musical theatre at the Royal Central School of Speech and Drama. And at Central, it kind of reignited this love of acting. And I've done loads of really fun things, like I've been a murder mystery actress for about 10 years now, which is great fun. I've been in quite a few musicals. I've been in pantomime for a few years as well. And 3 years ago, I got the job working at the Crystal Maze live experience in London, which, if you know the TV show, is just like the TV show. It was my favourite show when I was a kid. So 9-year-old Mandy is at home giving me a high five right now. She's like, yeah, you live the dream, girl. So I get to go and play games with people and be silly. And that's my dream.
That's fantastic. Did you know all the ways to get out, or did you ever get trapped in there?
I never want to leave. So what? I don't really want to know how to get out.
That's fantastic. So let's do a little bit, before going to the ukulele, classical. Go back to classical. What made you go from classical and mix the ukulele? Where was the transition? Why?
I trained as an opera singer. I trained in classical voice and got told I wasn't good enough to do opera. So I went and did musical theatre and trained in that, and I wasn't very good at that. And then I decided to go and join a metal band for 2 years. Wherever I can use my voice, I go. But After that finished, I then moved to a folk band, a 9-piece folk rock band. We were called Brides of Rain. And I had just started learning the ukulele at that point. So I was bringing the uke in, doing these really great folk arrangements. And the uke was really more of just a bit of fun. But 5 years ago, to close to the day actually, I met a chap by the name of George Bartle. And we were performing in a ukulele open mic. We were just doing solo sets and we were performing. And we got chatting afterwards. We went and had a couple of pints of beer at the pub, you know, as you do. And we got chatting and we both realised we'd trained as classical singers. Now, I hadn't done a lot of classical singing since my training. I kind of gave up on it, really. And after a couple of pints, we went, wouldn't it be ridiculous if we could combine ukulele with our classical training?
Don't worry, I'm here. I'll tell you all about it, all right? Sitting comfortably, good, I'll begin. The singer who made this next song famous bears a striking resemblance to George.
Go compare, go compare. To be sure, and you ensure first, go compare.
And 5 years later, we've been international, we play arts festivals, music festivals and ukulele festivals, and it's been ridiculous. We always say the best ideas come from being a little bit tipsy at the pub, and that's how it began, really.
He won't be mine.
You are called Opera-lele, which is a great name to combine the two. Tell us how it works. Is it a classical voice that leads and with finger picking, or is it finger picking classical? What's the mix?
We always say that we're singers first and ukulele players second. The ukulele came sort of secondary into our lives. So when we were finding material that would work for us, we first went to pieces that we already knew and we were quite familiar with, and then looking at how we can incorporate the chord progression and the original music into ukulele. We wanted to make sure that we were true and honest with the music and that we were performing it legitimately. We were really wanting to bring these pieces of music to life for people.
Sempre amabile, leggiadro viso, impianto in riso, e mezzognero. La donna è mobile, dal più mal vento, muta lo scento, e di pensiero.
So a lot of the pieces we do, we're strumming, but because there's two of us playing, what's great now is that we're finding different ways of changing that sound world. So there's George will do a lot of the picking. He does really brings in very classical guitar kind of techniques. He's got a lot of skill in that, and I sort of lead with quite a lot of strumming and looking at playing sort of up, further up the neck in versions. So we get to try these things out in rehearsal. We've tried quite a few songs and they've just not worked. So we're about being brave and trying something, and then if it doesn't work, that's fine. We put it in the bin, we move on. And we find pieces of music that anyone can enjoy.
That's a fantastic way of doing it. Is there a favourite everybody likes?
We always start with Funiculi Funicula. And we started having that as our first song. And people loved it. And then we started doing a few gigs where we didn't start with that song. And the audiences would come and go, oh, you didn't do the Funiculi Funicula song. So it has become our trademark, really.
The booze is kicking in, George, we're going to be okay.
So it gets everyone in a good mood, and that's what we want, for people to come to our show and know that they're going to be entertained and have a great time. So it sets the mood perfectly for us.
Well, of course, you've got the high voice, which I assume is soprano, and George could go down low, baritone, so harmonies and the separation must be really good.
Our voices seem to go really well together. People really like it, especially when we mix the harmonies. I mean, we don't always get on.
Body of a god.
Shame it's Buddha. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better. Tonight's bizarre enough.
I should have tried this.
No, you can. No, you can.
Like each other, it's just that we're best of frenemies, and you learn a little bit about how we both get on with each other.
Brilliant. So where can we see some of the songs and the videos? What's the website, Mandy?
If you go to operalele.co.uk or search for opera-lele on Google, we're the only ones silly enough to do this, so you'll find us. But yeah, and check us out on Facebook. That's where we're doing a lot of videos at the moment to keep you entertained during this very weird time.
Yes, it is a weird time. Let's hope it's over soon and we all get out and enjoy music as we should do. Can I ask you to please play a couple of bars and sing to play us out?
I would be delighted.
Bless you. Thank you very much for talking to us, Mandy.
Whoa. See.